Hey everyone, this is King Kong Rong, and welcome back to the channel. Today we've got the Pit of Heresy. This was my first, and definitely not my best attempt, but it was a lot of fun to tackle. But first, just a reminder that you can watch me live on Twitch at twitch.tv/KingKongRong25. I'm usually on Fridays at 10 p.m. Eastern, but check my Twitter at twitter.com/KingKongRong25 for any channel updates. Now, let's get into it. The pit is where you can get a weekly pinnacle drop, which is great. The only problem is that you'll probably die a lot from falling. Seriously, this dungeon is like 40% combat and 60% jumping around. I know. Whisper of the Worm and Outbreak Perfected, they all had tough jumping puzzles as well. But you know what? I tackled those after I did this dungeon, okay? Nevertheless, my team probably died more from falls than in combat. Still a lot of fun though.
Neither am I, can I just kind of... Guardian,
down. As you watch the gameplay, you'll notice my team is basically carrying me throughout. Again, it's my first time playing the dungeon, but I hope that seeing it from my perspective, you can see how a new player or a returning player might be a little overwhelmed. So from here on in, I'll narrate as little as possible so you can just follow along with the gameplay. But I will try to chime in when necessary to explain a few things if need be. Hope you enjoy!
Down.
Oh, shoot. Yeah, I know I can't take him on. So, what do? Just hang out? Thank you.
Okay.
Let me know when I'm in.
Green Bean gloves. Yeah, right.
So, in this section, there are several immortal ogres that are walking around, and my team is supposed to kill some knights, get their orbs, and then dunk them while making sure that the ogres don't see them, otherwise they'll just die. My job was to hunt around the tunnels to look for knights. Because again, I hadn't played this encounter before, I wouldn't have known what to do. But if it seems like I'm just running around endlessly in this cave, to be honest, I kind of am. The other role that I played in this was to, if I see an ogre, try to distract it so it would focus on me instead of my teammates who are going to be dropping those arc charges into a receptacle so that we can advance the encounter. Pardon me if it just looks like I'm running around in a cave blindly, because that is exactly what I'm doing.
I'm wandering around aimlessly. I understand.
Guardian down.
Oh shit. Meanwhile, Buck's doing the work, getting the corpse. Yikes.
Guardian down.
Wait, we got you the ogre?
I have well of reading.
Yep. Thank you.
Got it? Dreambreaker. Yeah.
Guardian down.
I made it somehow.
No, and that was just luck. I fell
down.
I don't know if you heard my voice there, but yeah, that was very lucky. I don't think I've had another perfect fall in that section.
And
the, you know, 7 or 8 times I've done the pit since this video was taken. And this next section, though, is the beginning of the real jumping hell that we were subjected to. I don't know if you noticed in that chamber, but there were 3 symbols on the wall that are supposed to signify the location of 3 enemies we have to kill in order to unlock the next encounter. However, I don't know about my teammates, but for me, I was just more focused on being able to find safe platforms to land while jumping, that I couldn't even focus on finding the right spot. I was just trying to stay alive.
Oh, you can make her alive.
Guardian down. Guardian down.
Heh.
Guardian down. Guardian down.
What was over there?
Guardian down.
I killed the thrall. What do you want me to do? You want me to try to hop over and do a revive? Calculated. Always is. Fell off there. Okay. Yes, let me know when and where to put it. This fight. Ugh. Yes. It's one where I ran around aimlessly, as I do in this map.
Finally, we are at the boss of the Pit of Heresy, Zulmak. The mechanics of this final encounter are a mix of everything we've faced thus far. So, each little tower here has a special enemy we have to kill with a sword in a particular fashion, just like in the very first encounter. Each each of those enemies will then drop an arc charge, which we then have to drop into these receptacles, just like one of the other encounters with the ogres. Now, similar to that, I will be running around in a circle, just like when I was in the caves, killing adds as I go, just to try to make way for my teammates who are going to drop those charges and then trigger the damage phase on the boss. As I play this more often, I'm hoping that I can have the confidence to just take on the guardians, those special enemies myself, so that we're a little more efficient. Because right with two teammates going after orbs and me clearing adds, I want to see if we can all do it so that each one of us takes an arc charge, drops it at the same time, and thus speeding our clearing time of this dungeon. But that'll be for a future video. In the meantime, you can just see how we're doing what we can to communicate so that I can draw the aggro of the boss, just like with the ogres, so that my teammates have a clear run of the deposit for their arc charge. So it only takes a couple bullets to make the boss turn my way, but that's all the time they need. Now he is. And dodged out of the last second. Okay, this guy. Come here. Hey, hey, hey. Thank you.
Yeah.
Okay, I revived right in front of the sword bear.
Called him out. Power bomb me.
Yeah.
here we are. Damage phase. Oh, unfortunately, one teammate went down early. That means we've got just seconds, really, to make it count. Oof. Now I'm down. Last Guardian standing is a Buck fan. Now, here, Buck could have probably revived any one of us, but he makes a great decision to just put in some final shots in and attack the boss. I can come out with the clutch. Now, the boss had already plunged his sword into the ground. If he had completed an animation, that would have ended damage phase and most likely have killed the last player and then wiped the team, which means we would have had to do this encounter all over again. So that was a great decision. Awesome play. I just loved that shot of him, of Buck, flying through the air and getting those hits in. So that was the Pit of Heresy. I really hope you enjoyed that video. It's, again, my first time running through this dungeon. I've completed it maybe 8 or so times since, so what I'd love to do is upload a cleaner, more efficient run and see if I can compare how I've progressed since this first video. So if you enjoyed this, please leave a like, and if you want to see more Destiny 2 content or even Monster Hunter World content, please subscribe. It really helps out the channel, and I just look forward to seeing you all in the next video. Thank you all very much for your time. Have a great one.